Morning to all, this is Harpreet and in this video session I'm going to discuss the rest part of our chapter, the last lesson. Already I told you about the first part. So we have read that there is a character friends and teacher Mr. Hamel, and the situation is of the time of war. There is a war between France and German. Now next, through the window, friend saw his classmates. They were already in their place because friends was late on that day. He was thinking to miss the class actually, but later on he decided to go to the school. Mr. Hamel walking up and down with his terrible iron ruler under his arm. Friends opened the door and went in. He blushed. And he was frightened because he was late, and that's why Mr. Hamel would scold him for being late. But Mr. Hamel very kindly asked him to go to his place. Down at his desk, by now he had got a little over his fright. He saw that his teacher was in his beautiful green coat and a frilled shirt. He had a little black silk cap all embroidered. He never wore this dress except on inspection and prize days. The whole school seemed so strange, but the thing that surprised friends most was that of the back benches. The village people were sitting quietly like little students. Among them were old Hauser. He was the former mayor, the former postmaster, and several others. Everybody looked sad. While little Franz was wondering about it all, Mr. Hamel began in a very grave and gentle tone. My children, this is the last lesson I shall give you. The order has come from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. The new master comes tomorrow. This is your last French lesson. I want you to be very attentive. These words came like a thunderbolt to little Franz. Now he understood what they had put up at the town hall. It was going to be his last French lesson. It was in honor of this last lesson that Mr. Hamel had put on his fine clothes. Now little friends understood why the old man of the village were sitting there in the back of the room. They were also sorry that they had not gone to school more often. Now they had come to thank Mr. Hamel for his 40 years of faithful service. While little friends was thinking all of this, he heard his name being called. He was asked to recite the rules of the participle, but he got mixed up on the first word and stood there holding on to his desk. His heart was beating fast and he did not dare to look up. Then Mr. Hamel talked of the French language. He said that it was the most beautiful language in the world. He said that when a people are enslaved, they can be said to have the key to their prison as long as they hold fast to their language. Then he opened a grammar and read his last lesson. Little Franz was amazed to see how well he understood it. Everything seemed so easy, and he had never listened so carefully, and Mr. Hamel had never explained everything with so much patience. It seemed as if he wanted to give his students all he knew before going away. After writing, they had a lesson in history, and then the babies chanted their ba-ba-ba-ba, and even old Hauser was crying. Mr. Hamel sat motionless in his chair, gazing first at one thing and then at another. It was as if he wanted to fix everything in his mind. For 40 years he had been there in the same place. It must have broken his heart to think that he had to leave it all. He could hear his sister moving about in the room above, packing their trunks. They were to leave the next day. After the writing, he spelled the letters with other children. All were crying. any attention on the roof. The pigeons cooed very low, and little Franz thought of himself, will they make them sing in German? All at once, the church clock struck 12. At the same moment, the trumpets of Prussian were heard. They were returning from the drill. Mr. Hamel stood up and began to say, my friends, but something choked him. He could not go on. Then he turned to the blackboard. He took a piece of chalk and wrote as large as he could, long live France. So this is the end of our chapter. Thank you. Have a nice day.